Greetings, everybody. Welcome to another edition of Rasslin with Redbeard, the YouTube show where I, Redbeard, go to a wrestling event and give you an idea of what it's like to be a wrestling fan traveling the highways and byways of this adventurous little business of ours. Joining me here this evening, as you can see, is my lovely wife, Jill.
Hi.
I know a lot of you have been wondering when she would make her return to the program. It's been quite a while. I think, I don't remember what number it was that you were on. It was the one for the Omega show in Cameron, North Carolina, but I'm glad to have her with us. She adds a touch of cuteness to the show that is greatly absent when myself and the other members of our cast are the ones who dominate your screen there. We're here this evening in Columbia, South Carolina for a WWE live house show. Yeah, that's not exactly an independent show by any means, but that's typically what I would cover on this program, but we're doing WWE here this evening because they're in town. And because this is, I think, one of the events that you would actually willingly come with me to.
It's safe.
Yeah, it's safe. Yeah, it's not a bar. I've told the story before about the old school championship wrestling show that we went to that was in the bar in Charleston that almost ruined your opinion of things. Yeah, so. But we're here in Columbia at the Colonial Life Arena. The show here this evening is going to be headlined by a street fight between John Cena and Seth Rollins. The funny thing about that is that the last time we went to a WWE event here, the main event was a street fight between CM Punk and Daniel Bryan and the team of the Wyatt family. Funny thing about that is that the Wyatt family no longer exists, and CM Punk and Daniel Bryan are pretty well no longer on the program at all. She's making faces in the camera here because I have the viewfinder turned around so she can see everything. Other matches on the card here from what there have been announced are going to include Dolph Ziggler and Luke Harper. Harper, of course, is the Intercontinental Champion at this point in time. We also will see a tag team match featuring the current tag team champions, that being Damian Mizdow and The Miz, being challenged by the new team of A New Day, which A New Day is a trio made up of Xavier Woods, Kofi Kingston, and Big E Langston. They're doing kind of a high-energy pastor, I don't want to call it a black church type thing, but that's what's been in the gimmick so far. But the whole thing is going to be pretty fun, I believe. Going to have a big turnout here. Anytime you got John Cena in the main event, in a town like ours, you're going to have a lot of people show up. So we're looking forward to seeing how this
pans out. Including my little cousins.
That's right. We're going to try and get them on the show here this evening. But we got some cousins of Jill's who are, how old are Justin and Brady?
I think 4 and 6.
Yeah, they are huge John Cena fans. And I really, really, really hope they have a ball here, because this is the type of thing that they would just eat up. You know, that's the right age for kids to be coming to something like this and to really get into it, because their minds still grasp things. They still have that great imagination that you only have when you're that age. So it'll be a lot of fun to see their reaction to this whole thing here, because this is their first show they've ever been to, if I'm not mistaken. I think Marianne said, their mom, Marianne, I think it's what she had said, this is their first one. But other than the goings-on of here this evening, we've got a lot going on in the realm of WWE, period. Of course, the talk of the town is the old CM Punk interview with Colt Cabana. A lot of things went on in that. I won't try and rehash all of it here. Everybody has their opinion on that. But the bottom line is that Punk did a fantastic job of protecting himself. I think it was Mike Johnson, but one of the guys from the staff at PW Insider had a great article about the fact that Punk basically saved his own life in doing what he did with that staph infection there. So you've got that going on. Ramifications of that will probably still be felt for weeks or not months. Other than that, in terms of WWE's product, there's the TLC pay-per-view, which is coming up here soon. The interesting thing about that is that the promo, the TV commercials that we've been seeing for this particular show have some wording in them along the lines of you're my Vanna White here all of a sudden. The wording in the promo for that particular show had something about a championship opportunity destroyed, and the stipulation going in the main event of TLC, it's a match between Seth Rollins and John Cena, is that if Cena loses, he loses his number one contendership title shot, whatever it is, against Brock Lesnar here coming up later on. So maybe a spoiler, or may just be something that won't ever really pan out too much. Who knows? But we'll see what happens. Other things, last video I recorded, I mentioned something about the fact that TNA, Impact Wrestling, whatever you want to call them, didn't have a TV deal. Well, they've got a TV deal now. They're going to be on Destination America, which is a Discovery Communications channel. That's no more weird than wrestling being on the Sci-Fi Network, so go figure with that. Mentioned one more thing here before we go in terms of local shows. There's a lot going on this weekend, so I won't mention those programs. The big show coming up here later this month, though, is Wrestle Forces Forsaken program, which will be happening at the Hangar in Casey, South Carolina, which is only about 5 miles from where we are presently. They've got the third in the series of matches between Cedric Alexander, who is the current champion for Wrestle Force, and John Skyler. They've gone to 2 time limit draws, and they're probably going to have something even more special for this third match in the series, so that'll be something you don't want to miss. All that having been said...
You talk a lot.
I do, and I'm very parched right now because it's kind of dry. Yeah, I like to, you know, express myself.
But anyway, we're going in here mm-hmm. to the Colonial Life Arena, mm-hmm. and we're going to go watch wrestling, so we'll let you know what happens.
Is there anything you're looking forward to here this evening?
I don't have a clue what I'm going to see, to be honest with you, because I haven't been keeping up with it at all, so don't know.
Don't know.
Yeah.
Okay. But of the shows that we've been to previously, you typically enjoy yourself at these
yeah.
WWE shows, right?
Yeah.
Is there, you know, pretty big deal?
Yeah.
Yeah. Pretty big deal. That's it. We're going to go ahead and head on inside. It's 6:30 right now. Show starts in about an hour. We'll give you some more insight when we get in and...
hopefully interview my cousins.
Yep. Might even have a few more people because from what I understand, a good many of our regulars are going to be here this evening as well. So appreciate you guys tuning in. We'll see you inside. Harlem Globetrotters. Thank you, sir.
You did good, fella.
Appreciate that. All right. wrestling fans in Columbia right now, right here with me, Brady and Justin. You Brady, and you're Justin. Are you guys looking forward to the show here this evening?
John Cena.
You're looking forward to seeing John Cena, huh? Who's John Cena going to be wrestling tonight?
Seth Rollins.
He is, isn't he? But who do you think is going to win?
Seth Rollins.
You think Seth Rollins is going to win?
Yes.
Well, Brady, who do you think is going to win?
Justin.
Who do you think is going to win, Brady?
That's Justin.
Oh, Justin, I'm sorry.
John Cena.
John Cena? Okay. You fellas look great in your outfits here, I have to tell you that. Mom and Dad do a lot of good things with these boys. Bringing them to shows like this is one of them. All right, fellas, there you go. All right, y'all enjoy the show.
Thank you. Madonna now, for Madonna. Standing 8 count, ref, come on.
Thank you.
out. He kicked out of the table spot. Oh, God. WWE Live. Got our whole crew here pretty much. Even Wayne, who's touting his championship title, which happens to be a copy of the Free Times of Columbia, where several of his photos appeared. Not always at the three of them. There you go. Not exactly at his permission at first, I don't believe, but they're there. Tell us what you guys think of the show here this evening. Billy, we'll start with you.
It was fun. It was good. Enjoy seeing Seth Rollins, Cesaro, and a bunch of the guys that I haven't seen before, live at least. That was fun.
There was a good mix of talent here this evening. A lot of guys I haven't seen before live. Some I haven't seen in a while live. So it's good to have everybody here on one particular show, especially guys like Cesaro, like you mentioned there. We have our mascot here for this evening.
Rey Mysterio. He didn't want to wrestle, so he just hung out with us.
Yeah, Rey Mysterio is just among the crowd here. So.
Actually, he's a little taller than Rey.
Yeah, a little bit. He's got lifts in his shoes. So
that's right.
Yeah. K-Dog, what did you think about the show here this evening?
Yeah, I enjoyed it. I enjoyed like you said, seeing people I haven't seen before live, Luke Harper and Dolph Ziggler, I enjoyed that match. Dolph Ziggler steals the show every time. And seeing Charlotte for the first time, I've only heard about her. So that was
something else I was particularly interested in, was seeing Charlotte, because she's the NXT Women's Champion right now. And
right.
You don't often see her on the house show loops there, but she was here this evening, so that was pretty cool.
Yeah,
I'll ask you this question. Since you're bringing kids here with you to the show, do you feel this is a value in terms of ticket price versus what you actually get out of a show like this?
Yeah, I do. I mean, they have a blast, and we got the cheap seats, $17, so couldn't have anything more. John Cena, of course, in the main event, so it was well worth it.
That's one of the good things about the Colonial Life Arena, is that I don't think there's really a bad seat in this building.
No, that's definitely true. That's why I heard they were coming, just give me the cheap seats, and we'll have a blast.
Something that was funny to me, I don't know if you guys noticed this or not, but the limited view, quote-unquote, section was two sections that would have normally been behind the staging, but here this evening it was actually pretty ideal in terms of the position, because you could see above the ring and all that.
I was wondering what that was. I saw it say limited view. I was like, what is that?
Yeah, that's what that was.
So. It is strange how they price things for the Colonial Center, how certain areas are $50, certain are $27.
Yeah, when there's really not a bad seat in the house anyway.
Yep.
That's true.
All right. Mr. Rush, you have anything to add? Would you like to say anything about the Professional Wrestling Awards of the Carolinas? No.
They're still being developed.
They are.
Nominations going on, voting going on.
It's going to be something else, I think, whenever we get done with these things.
I hope.
But it's going to be good.
I would like to agree with Robert Keller.
Yes.
WrestleForce, end of December, people should come.
Yep. WrestleForce, that's going to be the Forsaken event, correct?
Yes.
Yes. Yep. Skyler Alexander 3.
Three, yes.
All right, fellas. Appreciate everybody tuning in and for coming out here this evening.
Thank you.
Seeing everybody again on the program.
Yes, sir. Good to see you.
Do we look tired?
Do we?
Because it was a long show.
Yeah, that was a pretty long show. The matches, several of them seemed very drawn out. The main event in particular, there were a lot of stalls, a lot of segments that kind of ran on. Apparently there was someone at ringside that was crying.
A little girl.
Because Cena was getting his butt kicked. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Still real to me. Thoughts overall on the show, though, now that I've screwed you up to where you can't talk?
Overall it was okay. I just thought that the matches were a little long and there needed to be a little more something.
Yeah.
And so it just there were a lot of kids here, which made it a lot of fun because you could hear them chanting and they got really into it, which makes it so much fun because there's two seats down from us was this little kid and he was just chanting and I would have was watching him more than I was watching the show just because he was so cute. But it was really fun to see how my cousin's reactions to when John Cena came out because those boys and their mama and daddy were really into it. So it was really cute.
Yeah, the kids especially, it's fun to watch their reactions because they get such a kick out of it. You know, it's great to see them respond and to have them be able to enjoy a program like this because it's, you know, when you boil wrestling down, it's a classic battle between good and evil. When it's done well, it comes off great, and in the minds of young people like that, they're bigger than life. So I agree with what Jill was saying there, though. Some of the matches, they just were lacking some pizzazz there. There wasn't a whole lot really to latch on to in terms of just, I don't know, anything really all that entertaining. You know,
I mean, I'm trying to even think of a favorite match, and I honestly...
Probably Sandow, or Ms. Dow, excuse me.
Oh my gosh, he is hilarious. Yeah. I could literally watch him mimic The Miz all day long.
Yeah.
It was hilarious.
Yeah, I thought going in that Luke Harper and Dolph Ziggler would have been a match of the night, and their match was not bad by any stretch of the imagination, but it was, you know, I think they were intentionally holding back a little bit, and this is me being, you know, the indie smart guy, but... it just didn't seem like they were really putting as much into it as they would have been if this had been like, you know, a TV or pay-per-view type thing. What blew me away here this evening, though, was R-Truth winning a match against Cesaro.
Yeah, that was wrong.
Yeah. I haven't seen R-Truth on TV in gosh knows when. And he won a match against Cesaro, somebody who's been on TV, been involved in, you might as well say, main event storylines here recently. Somebody might be in the doghouse. But with that we're going to call it a night here. This has been episode 12 of Rasslin with Redbeard. As you might be able to see, guys walking behind us with $5 fake WWE t-shirts.
$5.
They're going to be out here probably till every car is out of the parking lot. So with that, we're going to get out of here ourselves. Hope you guys enjoy the program. If you like what you see, click that like button. Give me a subscribe. Always helps out. This has been... Yeah, she doesn't know the YouTube lingo at all.
And this has been my second show.
Second one. A lot of you guys have been saying you need to have your wife back on there. Well, here she is. She's really lovely, isn't she? I love her.
You're a mess. I love you too. Ooh, sappiness.
We'll see you guys down the road.